This is actually the store that I created before, just to give you a better idea what your actual store can look like. So up here we have a slider, we have the products of the week, and we have more shop information, including the newsletter. So you can click on each of the individual products and you will receive more information. Here you can see the price just dropped from $40 to $25. So this could make it more interesting for a potential customer. Let's start by looking at the Shopify main website and sign up for an account. In this case, we choose the online store. And we click Next. Now we fill in our information. So Shopify wants to make sure that they can offer us their best service. So they actually asked us a couple of questions like, do you already have products? In this case, I'm just playing around, but you would obviously choose whichever option is the right one for you. So what will you sell? Again, I'm not sure yet, so I just chose this option. And I'm setting up a store for myself, so I don't have to check this box. After you created an account, you will see this page. This page is the dashboard. So on this dashboard, on the left, we see the menu, which I will talk about later. And in the main area, they show you three steps that you need to take in order to launch your store. So let's actually start by looking at the store that we just created. So I would do this by just opening up a new tab, right click and open a new link in Chrome. You might have a different browser, so it might say something similar, but you know how it works. So this is the web store that we just created. Already looks pretty nice. However, we don't really have any products in here, and we probably want to change a little bit of the design. So let's move back onto our dashboard. So the first thing we want to do on our dashboard is to add a product. So we click on Add Products, and now we choose a title. So adding a red blouse. And here we can fill in a description. Then we want to add the type. So in this case, the type I would give is probably just blouse. This becomes interesting when you have a big store with like many, many different products and many, many different types. So the vendor in this case is just myself. So I would just add like probably my name. Next, we want to choose the price. I'm just going to say it's going to cost $25 and it's on markdown from $30. So typically a SKU is associated with any purchasable item in the store. So for example, the blouse of a particular style and size might have a SKU of some particular number and edits a size at the end. So for example, I'm just going to say like the SKU of this particular item is 1000L. So 1000 is just an arbitrary number that I want to give this item, and the L stands for the size. In this case, we also want to charge for taxes, and we always require a shipping address because we want to make sure that we can only ship to people in the United States. The inventory allows us to have Shopify track our inventory or not to track it at all. So the difference is maybe you're selling an ebook or like any type of digital goods. So you probably have an infinite amount of the ebooks that you can sell. However, if you're selling bracelets, you only have a fixed amount of bracelets. So say for the blouse, our quantity is 3. So after we sold 3 of the blouses, it will be shown as sold out, or it just won't be available anymore for anyone else to purchase. This makes it actually very, very easy for us to make sure that no one sends us money and we cannot ship the item for them. So we can also determine if this product has multiple options. So for example, let's say we wanna offer this blouse in different sizes. For example, we have one in large, we have one in small, and that's fine already. We can always add more options, for example, the color, the material, the style, or we can create a completely new option that's not mentioned yet. So the next step is to add an image or multiple images. In this case, I just choose an image that I have already created. So I choose the red blouse image. And next we can add this product to a collection. So a collection could be, for example, I could create a collection called blouses. And in this blouses collection, I would just add all the products which are blouses. So that would allow the user to easily sort and search through your site. It's basically like a category. However, we can also add this product to the collection front page, which adds the product to the front page. So after we edit the product to our front page, we want to give it a couple of tags. So in this case, I want to give it the tag blouse and red. Again, this makes it much, much easier for your customer to search for products. Now, if someone enters blouse into the search on your website, this product will show up. The same for the keyword red. And because we want to make sure that search engines can find us, we can specify a better title, the meta description. And if we want to change the URL, we can do this as well. So I will actually explain the search engine optimization for your web shop in later tutorials. So for now, I would just leave it by the title that you gave this product, and the meta description and the URL can also stay the same. The visibility allows you to decide whether or not you want to show this product right now, if you want to show it at a later point, or if you want to hide it completely. And now we click save. And we just added our first product to our store. So let's go ahead and add another product. So in this case, we have a black blouse. We add the description again. The type is already filled in. The vendor is already filled in this case. This one we actually want to sell for $20. And it's on sale from $24. And the SKU this time, because I already added a blue blouse as well, it's going to be 1003, enlarge, charge taxes, require the shipping address. We also want to track the inventory again. This time we have quantity of 2. And again, we have multiple options. So we want to add the size as large, small. For the black blouse, choose the image. And again, add it to our front page. So for the text, I'm just gonna add blouse, black. And we leave everything the same here. You can obviously modify it if you like, but just for the purpose of showing this, it should be fine like this. And we want it to be visible as of now. So now we're done adding products. So we can go back to our dashboard. Here we already have a nice preview of our web store, how it looks currently. But let's open it up if you still have the tab open, else just click view your website or open it up in a new link. So in this case, I'm just going to refresh it. And there we go. There are three products. And still all the other information that we will look at in a little bit. So let's go back to our web store. So now we have two more steps to go.